मनोह्लादयते यस्मात् क्रियं चापि ददति हि तस्मत् सुमनसः प्रोक्ता नरैः सुकृतकरमभिः देवताभ्यः सुमनसो यो ददति नरः शुचिः तस्मात् सुमनसः प्रोक्ता यस्मत् तुष्यन्ति देवताः. फ्लवर्स रिप्रेजेंट द ग्रेटेस्ट ब्यूटी ऑफ नेचर. फ्लवर्स मेक द एनवायरमेंट पॉजिटिव एंड ब्लिसफुल. द वर्ड पूजा इज मेड ऑफ टू सिलेबल्स. पू मीन्स फ्लवर्स एंड जा मीन्स चैंटिंग एंड वाटर. देयरफॉर द वर्ड पूजा डिनोट्स ऑफरिंग ऑफ फ्लावर्स. अवर ट्रेडिशन होल्ड्स ग्रेट सिग्निफिकेंस इन ऑफरिंग फ्लावर्स टू गॉड्स एंड गॉडेसेस. Let us see the flowers that please particular gods and goddesses. Lord Shiva is the destroyer of the universe and the ultimate power. Lord Shiva is never offered lovely flowers as he loves Dhatura, dry lotus, kaner, kusum, aak, kush, etc. We can find bel tree outside Shiva temples along with white champa tree. Often the plants of Juhi and other jasmines are allowed to climb on these trees for their fragrant flowers. Lord Ganesha, the lord of obstacle removal, accepts red flowers. Red marigold pleases him a lot. Marigold is the only flower of the gods that can be distributed with its petals. Red hibiscus is also a preferred flower offered to Lord Ganesha. Goddess Lakshmi is known to bring abundance and good fortune. The goddess sits on an open lotus and hence it is considered as her favorite flower. On every Wednesday, white-colored fragrant flowers like tuber rose and mogra, also chrysanthemum, are offered to Lakshmi Mata. Goddess Saraswati is always clad in white as she signifies purity of mind and soul. But her favorite color is yellow. If she is offered champa, yellow palash, it is considered very auspicious. Yellow variety of sunflower, rose, allamanda can also be offered. Goddess Parvati can be pleased with the flowers that can be offered to Lord Shiva. One can also offer white lotus, bel, palash, madar, apamarg, champa and chameli. Goddess Durga can be offered red flowers. Lotus, mogra flower and bel leaves can also be offered. Lord Vishnu is also known as the preserver of the universe. He likes lotus, maulasari, juhi, chameli, ashoka, malti, vasanti, kadam, kevra, champa and vaijayanti. Apart from fragrant flowers, he loves tulsi leaves. Lord Hanuman is offered chameli flowers and garland made of tulsi. Lord Krishna had brought Parijata, which is a heavenly tree, to earth. He is also offered kadamba flowers that are fragrant. He also loves tulsi leaves. Lord Surya is offered lotus flower. Lord Dattatreya is offered jasmine, bilva and audambara leaves. Shani is offered blue colored flowers. Lord Rama likes chameli flowers. Apart from these flowers, there are certain flowers and leaves that are not offered to certain gods and goddesses. Lord Shiva is not offered champa, ketaki and kevda because they were cursed by Shiva. Goddess Parvati is not offered arka and amla. Lord Ganesha is not offered ketaki flower and tulsi leaves. Lord Vishnu does not accept akshada. Lord Rama is not offered early. Lord Surya is not offered bilva leaves. There are certain benefits of offering flowers to deities. Lily for more wealth, Indian tulip for better health, vadamalli to overcome the fear of death, jasmine for family peace, hibiscus for spiritual strength and better health, rose to fulfill wishes, crepe jasmine to be blessed with a child, lotus for more wealth and intelligence, Arabian jasmine for professional growth, oleander to repay debts. On the whole, a flower has a particular color and a special fragrance. On a subtle level, the color and fragrance present in the flower have a capacity to attract the principles of a specific deity, which benefits the worshipper. That is the principle behind offering specific flowers to a deity. Om Namah Shivaya.